Honorable Leader of the New Democratic Party.
Mr. Speaker, I'd like to continue this line of questioning of the Premier. Certainly the Premier is right that this is no matter to be taken in at all lightly, that doctors will not be able to be offering these oncology clinics going forward in New Glasgow, in Yarmouth, and that people in these parts of the province now are going to have to travel to the city if they need cancer care. And also not at all to be taken lightly is the analysis of the cause of this that's been offered by Dr. Drew Bethune, medical director of the Nova Scotia Cancer Care Program. What he said about it is that the cause is that medical oncologists are no longer able to manage their tremendous workloads in this context. And he goes on to speak about the real concern that there will be people in parts of the province who are going to maybe altogether forego treatments that they should receive because of this change. So, Mr. Speaker, I want to ask the Premier if he agrees that this situation is evidence of a real human resources crisis in the healthcare system.
The Honourable Premier.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I want to thank the gentleman for the question. Mr. Speaker, he is highlighting Dr. Bethune and all of the physicians across this province. Mr. Speaker, done a tremendous job. His assessment, Mr. Speaker, is one that they've been looking at, wanting to add more physicians as part of that oncology team that is going across the province. It's what we're working with them. At the same time, we're in negotiations, Mr. Speaker, dealing with some of the very issues that Dr. Bethune was referring to, and ones that we're hoping that we can find a positive resolution for, not only for the support of those physicians who are feeling the pressure, Mr. Speaker, but also for those patients who require that comfort to know that that support will be there for them.
The Honourable Leader of the New Democratic Party.
This human resources issue and crisis, the trouble is it's not isolated. People in Cape Breton today are reluctant to turn up at the regional because they don't want to be adding to the chaos there, and surgeries and admissions are being cancelled because the regional is overfilled with patients who can't get repatriated to their home hospitals in North Sydney and Glace Bay because doctors there are so overtaxed they're not able to provide any more inpatient care. Now, Mr. Speaker, I understand the Premier often points to the improvements he's anticipating and looking forward to with the redevelopment plan, but would he not agree that a very sharp hospital human resources issue exists in the CBRM that the government needs to address today?
The Honourable Premier.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. We continue, Mr. Speaker, to work with all parts of this province to ensure that we have the right health care complement, Mr. Speaker, in every community, whether it's at the regional hospitals in parts of our province, or whether it's at rural community hospitals or collaborative care centres, ensuring that we have the appropriate health care teams there and the supports for them, Mr. Speaker. We will continue to work with them. As I said, the ongoing negotiations with doctors in Nova Scotia are to address some of the very issues the Honourable Member is raising in the House, Mr. Speaker. Some of those are related to compensation, Mr. Speaker, and we look forward to finding a resolution to that.
The Honourable Leader of the New Democratic Party.
Mr. Speaker, human resources everywhere. This week until next Monday, the emergency department in Tatamagoosh will be closed from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. The emergency department in Pugwash is closed the same hours. Sheet Harbour's emergency department closed from 7 p.m. until 7 the next morning, every night till next Thursday. And that's not to speak of the by now but routine closures at Glace Bay and at the Northside General. Every one of these closures at its core is a human resources question of staffing shortages of nurses and doctors. Mr. Speaker, emergency room closures for this reason have doubled under the current government. Does the Premier not see any connection between this and the way that his government has alienated and overburdened and disrespected medical personnel across the province?
The Honourable Premier.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I want to thank the Honourable Member for the question. Mr. Speaker, you know, during his tenure in office, Mr. Speaker, they changed to the CEC model, which was providing the very changes to those emergency rooms which they saw coming. Mr. Speaker, the adaption that we're going to continue to make as we go through, part of this is the way people practice today, Mr. Speaker, in many of our rural hospitals where we used to have a number of opportunities where physicians had privileges in those, required privileges in those. That is no longer the case. Those physicians can work in communities providing primary care without ever needing or requiring or wanting to work in a rural hospital or in a place. So we need to make sure that we have adapted and required enough physicians to deal with why we've adapted the hospitalist model when it comes to the regional hospitals, why we need to look at what we're going to do in those rural hospitals, Mr. Speaker, and that is all part of the conversation and negotiation we're having with Doctors Nova Scotia to address those very changing needs, not only to those of the patients, but quite frankly, for those who want to practice.